scripture is Jeremiah 3:15. And I will give you pastors according to mine heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding.
Let's pray. And the Father will call us again to say thank you for the opportunity to come and tell our pastor how much we appreciate, how much we need every and each action that they have taken on our behalf. We thank you for allowing him to speak to you for us, to step in for us, to render prayers of forgiveness, prayers for healing, prayers for understanding. We just say thank you for using our pastor in a mighty way. We thank you for the 13 years you have placed him here with us. We thank you for all the services, the sermons rendered. We thank you for the acts of kindness. We thank you for the care given to our loved ones in hospitals and convalescent centers. We thank you for his helpmate by his side, faithfully. We just thank you for all his efforts, his labor. And we know that he will be rewarded someday in heaven. And the Father, I ask that you continue to uplift him. We ask for his return here at Goler Metropolitan so that he can complete the works that he has started. And the Father, I thank you for the ministerial staff that assist him. We thank you for their efforts, their willingness to go and call upon. We thank you for their willingness to stand in, fill in, and do whatever needs to be done in his absence. And Father, I just thank you for all that you've done here at Goler Metropolitan, and I look forward to the many, many achievements yet to come. This and all things I ask.
So today, I'm going to list something out. Today we are elated to recognize our pastor, Reverend Dr. Johnny L. Ruff, in appreciation for all he does for our church. His commitment to the church is endless. Reverend Ruff, it is apparent that you love the Lord and want this organization, congregation, to accept the word of God and live a life full of love. Today we acknowledge your commitment to the Goler Metropolitan AME John Church family. Thank you for your many prayers and guidance throughout the year. Sister Ruff, we thank you for being an outstanding First Lady and your commitment to God, Brother Ruff, and our church. Thank you, and we love you with the love of Christ.
This time, we're going to ask our organizations to come forward. We're going to ask that the trustees and representatives from the people of Washington come forward. We're going to ask that Christian Education and the Capital Reserve Committee all stand up. Chairman of the trustee board, I give Reverend Ruff credit for something that doesn't happen to most people
You can get two people together and they would never agree on everything. But I find Reverend Ruff to be one of those people who can, while we're having a meeting and we kind of not agree with each other, you know, how to come in and smooth it out without taking sides on either one. So that's what I see from my pastor, Jadiel Ruff. And here is a token from our trustee board.
And I thank you, Reverend Ruff.
I worked with the trustees, and I think about time to let someone else carry the path, carry it out. And thank you very much for being captain.
From the cathedral choir. He said he had one word to say, so I got three little words. The simpler the best. Good morning to Reverend and Mrs. Ruff. We are definitely just overwhelmed with gratitude for all that you do for our church. And we take this opportunity to say thank you on behalf of the Board of Christian Education. We were asked to select one word that we identify or describes our pastor. And the word I have is integrity. Dictionary.com defines it as adherence to moral or ethical principles, which as Christians we would define as biblical principles. Integrity involves consistency as well. Someone who always does the right thing. And this word applies also fittingly to Reverend Ruff as well as Mrs. Ruff. And our scripture reference comes from Proverbs 21:3. To do what is right and just is more acceptable to the Lord than sacrifice. Thank you so much. We love you.
While Capital Reserve is making their way, I want to ask that the Board of Finance and Deaconess or the next.
Good afternoon, everyone. I mistakenly put the gift in the basket. That blue envelope, so don't have anything to give you right now, but it's in the basket. But the word that I would like to use to describe our pastor and first lady is leadership. They are amongst the two greatest leaders that I have ever had the opportunity to work with because they are genuine people. They are just everyday folk, and I know the part of that is because they're from South Carolina, and that's just what we do. That's just how we are. But But I do want to say that they are spiritual leaders, people who you can just talk to about anything, and they keep us as a church family uplifted, and they're so positive. And they, when you think things are going one way, you know, Reverend Ruff said, just keep the faith, just keep on with, it's going to be all right. And I'm one of those people that Mr. Dunlap was talking about on the trustee board. I'm going to have a different opinion, but Reverend Ruff always sees the way to bring us all that together, and that's what I love about it and thank him for. And I just want you to know, on behalf of the Capital Reserve Committee, he just helps us and keeps us encouraged and says yes to just about everything we want to do, even though I know people will say, well, they do it. But Reverend Ruff will say, let's give it a try, and we appreciate him for that. So with that said, just want to say thank you to our Reverend and Mrs. Ruff, and we're so happy to know that you're coming back to be with us again this year. God bless both of you.
Amen.
Good afternoon, church family. I am going to do the Board of Finance first. This message comes from the Board of Finance, the Women's Home and Overseas Missionary Society, and the Deaconess Board. You have demonstrated that God called you into ministry. It is an honorable thing to be pastored by a man who genuinely loves the Lord and his people. We are grateful for having you as part of our lives. You've shown us the path to go, and we really appreciate you. Mrs. Ruff, pastors are special, but a pastor's wife is a blessing. You have faithfully stood by the man of God's side with love, support, encouragement, and faith, demonstrating true devotion to him and the work he has been called to do. The wife of a pastor is a unique position. It is not for the anxious or the timid. We love you. Thank you.
First of all, I'd just like for everyone to know that I'm not trying to be cool this morning. I have a little problem with my eye, and it was suggested that I try not to have too much light coming in, so therefore I'm wearing these things to keep the light away. But Tommy had asked us to come up with one word we thought about our pastor, and we collectively, as a Board of Finance, thought and thought and thought. And one day at dinner, we all got together and we came up with this word. And the word I think is very perfect for Reverend Ruff. That is the word love. You've heard it over that we love Reverend Ruff. We know that Reverend Ruff loves to play golf. We know that Reverend Ruff loves to fish. We know that Reverend Ruff loved him some Jimmy Ruff. And I could continue with the word love for a number of times, but I know we have limited. But I would just like to say to our pastor from the Board of Finance, we love you, we love you, and we love you. Thank you for being our pastor, and we look forward to you coming back to Goler Metropolitan for another lovely year. I say I'm trying to be cool with myself. I'm going to ask that the class leaders and gospel choir, if you would, make your way down. And I ask that the lay council and the ushers stand ready.
afternoon. Representing the class leaders, I went, I guess you could say church-wide, because the class leaders are in touch with their members who are church members. And to come up with one word, I asked each of them, and I will share the words with you that they shared with me about our pastor. Altruistic, dedicated, considerate, helpful, teacher. And all of this is on display when he is with us in our class leaders meeting every month. And we certainly appreciate you joining us and helping us to become better class leaders, Dr. Ruff. And during our class leaders meeting, he takes time with us, he explains, he answers questions, and he is an exceptional teacher. And to Mrs. Ruff, you're the best First Lady in all of Zion. And we thank you both so much. We love you.
Good afternoon, everybody. First of all, I just want to say it can't be just one word to describe our pastor and his wife. But as I have said before, when God sent you all to us, that was the best thing he did for this church in many years.
Amen.
You are a tall drink of water. You are a strong man. And you are a loyal man, and you are a friend. And as I said, me being the president of the gospel choir, we have not sung in a long time, but you gave me the go-ahead to find a musician, and I'm doing my best to find one where the gospel choir can be back in session again. And as they said earlier, there's no better First Lady than Miss Ruff. She is the sweetest lady, and she's down to earth. She's not all this and that. And that's what I like about her, because as far as myself, I'm real, and I like real people. So I just want to say thank y'all. And I know you're going to be back. I ain't going to say you will. I know you're going to be back.
Good afternoon. Would all the members of the senior usher board please stand? First, I just want to say we do love you both. We just love you. And I think everybody in here shares that sentiment. So I cannot speak off the cuff like everybody else, but I wrote something down that I came across. So we were asked to come up with one word that would describe our pastor. But there are many words I could think of to describe Erwin Ruff. But the word I came up with is a compound word. And that word is servant leader. So a servant leader, the main goal of a servant leader is to serve others and not look to their own interests. They are leaders, but they do not flaunt power and authority over people, but serve them as described in Matthew 20:25-28. Wycliffe Bible translators explain that a servant leader does not want to make his name known, but to make God's name known, and have the ability to love and respect the people in their care. They possess integrity, humility, kindness, gentleness, patience, empathy. They are trustworthy and are good stewards over the people God has placed under their care. They are careful to give instruction and encouragement as to how to serve God well, And we know we get that every Sunday and in Bible study as well, and in our class leaders' meetings. I think we can find all these qualities in Reverend Ruff, and thus believe he can definitely be described as a servant leader. He has continued to lead us, providing us with sound teaching and encouraging us to read and study the Word of God, and to go out and spread the gospel, and to serve the needs of others. Reverend Ruff is our servant leader, and he has set the example for all of us to follow. The senior usher board is grateful to God for our servant leader and his helpmate, Mrs. Jameson Ruff. She has done a yeoman's job. She has exceeded all expectations of a first lady of our church, and she has worked tirelessly alongside Reverend Ruff to help our church become an even more successful ministry. So we just want to say we love you, we appreciate you, and we thank God for the both of you. That's it. Thank you.
Good afternoon, Goler family. Dr. Ruff, Ms. Ruff, I really can't say enough about you guys. Tell the truth. I might have to borrow a Thomas name. I was looking up leadership. And I know about leadership. I just, the picture of Reverend Ruff came to me, and I said, well, I don't need to look this up, because I know what leader is. When I retired and I came back here, Reverend Ruff was my pastor, and I walked in the office, and I introduced myself, and my life changed. I became a different person by just being introduced to this. And when I see them together, I look at them as a team. They come here as a team. They work here diligently as a team. They made us all better. We all became better people. We all became leaders when we didn't even know that we were leaders. And that's what I like to say. About a man that stands so tall and speaks so gracefully about all of us, I cannot explain any more than that. But like you said, all the people who came up here today, I look at and I give everybody a nickname, and I give Reverend Ruff and Ms. Ruff a nickname, the Coolers, because they come everything that we do down to attend. Because we can get our raises sometimes, but they keep us in this way. Thank you. Thank you for being a pastor. Thank you for being a friend. Thank you for being able to tell me when I'm wrong and when I'm right. I thank you.
Missions and the health ministry and any other organization that would like to share.
I would like to ask the members of the Home Missions Ministry to stand with me, please, wherever you are. And to Dr. and Mrs. Ruff, I would just like to say thank you for the leadership that you have given our church family through the years. You've truly been a blessing to us. And Mrs. Ruff, just a side note, thank you for being a friend and being there every time I needed you. I appreciate that. I thank God for sending us a shepherd and a first lady that demonstrates such genuine love, caring, and kindness to all of us. And we do appreciate all that you do. My word would be authentic, and I don't think that needs to be paraphrased, because whatever you do, you are authentic and you mean it from the heart. And I truly appreciate both of you.
Good afternoon, church family.
Amen.
It's good that I'm the last person, because everything that you always said really captures what I would say about Reverend Ruff. One of the things I remember when Reverend Ruff was first, before he came to go, I attended the conference, the convention, and Bishop Bonnie Hines preached. And I remember a sermon, as you said, when you come into your church, you come in looking at the cross. She said, she told the minister to come in looking at the cross. And this is what I saw about Reverend Ruff when he came in looking at the cross. He's still looking at the cross. And all the things that he's done, he's full of love, he's careful. And the good thing about it, he doesn't venture far away from it. But I was told to just have one word. And this word is from the health ministry. Remember the health ministry, when you still stand those things. But you stand, not still standing, but you're standing. I'm glad to help each of you. I've been the president of the health ministry since 2013. And Reverend Ruff has been here during that tenure. But the name that we came up with was, he's diplomatic. And all the things that Mr. Billup talked about, the things how he can smooth over meetings and all that, being a diplomat helps you do that. Reverend Ruff carries all of that. He's faithful. He's loyal. All of these things are important for our church. And he's a great leader. And he has inside of him a beautiful wife that is, people have used the word genuine. That fits her, genuine, full of love. And she's always the same. She's always keeping, she always keeps me laughing. When I'm down, I think of Kimmy and I start laughing. She just makes my day. And I just thank God for both of you, and I just hope you all will continue. And I know Bishop Stearns is going to sing you back. Thank you.
At this time, we will hear from the men's boosters and presentation from our children's department.
Good afternoon, church family.
Good afternoon.
After you heard everybody else, my word has been tossed aside. And Mr. Morgan, how many minutes do I have?
How long have you
been working? About an hour. The word I came up with was uplifting. Reverend Ruff uplifts everyone. Everyone he comes in contact with, whether it's physically, mentally, or spiritually, he uplifts people. He encourages people. He tend to send him to another level. And I just wanted to say that I'm very proud that he's my minister. He's a good friend of mine. But I will say, every Sunday when I leave here, spiritually, I am uplifted. About midweek, I tend to drain a little bit. I go to Facebook, listen to the sermon again, and all of a sudden my spirits are up again. You know, I come in on Sunday morning, sometimes I'm dragging. He said, Ron, how you doing? I said, I'm dragging a little bit, Reverend Ruff. He gave me words. words of encouragement. All of a sudden, I'm full of energy. It's like, well, I'm a diabetic. So he's like a shot of sugar to me. And Ms. Ruff, I really appreciate you. I can't describe you in one word. So what I say to Ms. Ruff is, you are a super duper supreme, superior woman of God.
Children wanted to sing for you this morning, but we didn't know whether or not we could schedule the rehearsal. So after seeing so many of them come in this morning, I just took it upon myself to ask them if they would like to come down and give Reverend and Mrs. Ruff a great big shout.